Okay, today I will show you. We have here Audi A6, the type 4F. It means from 2004 and newer. And it is the typical failure of the steering clock. So you can see the key are inside. You can try to switch on the car, but it doesn't. It looks like the battery is exhausted, but it's not true. It's a question and issue of the steering clock, and the steering clock unit is located here. This is the silver box. You can see there are two wiring harness connected. So you have to basically remove that plastic which is below the steering wheel. One bolt is here from that side, and two bolts are on the bottom, one here and second there. I am able to deactivate the unit. I will open it up, I will put it into the programmer, and I will load the emulator into that, so you do not have the issue with the steering clock anymore. You do not need to pay the amazing price which Audi and VW is asking for it, because they will not sell you just the unit, they will sell you the whole steering rack, and you can save a lot of money if you will send me the unit and I can put the emulator for you. So to send me the unit, everybody is thinking that it's holding here on that screws, but it's not true. You do not need to remove that that screws. If you remove them, you will not be able to pull the unit out anyway, because the unit is holding on the three screws on or three bolts from upside. Yeah, there are three bolts upside and one mark yellow by here, which has to be removed to be able to pull the unit out. So this is the remove unit. You can see that this was the yellow bolt, and here are the bolts from the upside I mentioned, which are holding the whole unit. One here, second here, and third here. So you just need to remove 1, 2, 3 and yellow, and then send me the unit. Inside is such electronics which I am able to put into the programmer via the programming pads here, and load the emulator into that. You can see the offer for the let me say renew the units or repair the units. I do not recommend it, because that repair usually means that they will change the micro switches for you, sometimes the relay, but it's not all the time the issue. Yeah, so the issue can be somewhere else, and it's much more worth it and to be sure to completely deactivate the unit. Deactivate means that the steering clock will not lock anymore. Your steering will still be unlocked. But the immobilizer, and if you have the alarm and so on, will still be functional and active. So there is the minimal risk from the security perspective for the car stealers. Yeah. So, short comment. If you need to remove the unit, you need to go the upside as mentioned. And to be able to do that, you need to unscrew that four bolts. 1, 2, and on the opposite side there is 3, 4, and it happens that the complete steering wheel will fall down, yeah, and you will be able to go from the upside to remove the unit. I recommend, if you are a skilled guy, okay, you will be able to do that probably, and for that who are not so mechanically skilled, then I recommend to give it to the car service or will be able to remove it for you, and you can send the unit to me. I recommend all the time, usually in most cases, in 90% of the cases, you can connect the locked car into the diagnostic. You will go into the failure searching mode, and you will find that into that unit there is a stored failure 00288, a steering lock defective. And if you erase that failure, if you will erase it, the car will start and will be able to move again. But it's only temporarily fixed, because it will happen in a question. It's just question of the time. Sometimes it's the same day, sometimes it's in 3 months when the unit will be locked again, because simply there is still some mistake, some failure which has to be fixed. And by erasing the failure, you will not fix anything. You will just postpone the problem for the future. Okay, so I will open the unit, will load the emulator in, and will show you in a while how the unit behave when the emulator is loaded in. So we are back into the same car. The unit is now assembled back, deactivated. I can put the key in. Let me show you. Put the key in. And usually you hear the noise of the steering lock doing dish dish. Just unlock or lock. Now it's silent because the unit is deactivated. And it will confirm the start and will let you start. You can hear the rattle from the engine. It's not good, but it's not the issue of that video. And again, if you remove it, it will be silent because the unit is deactivated. The steering lock is still unlocked and the issue is solved. Again, I recommend that deactivation more than repairing or renewing the unit, because about 40% of my customers are people who let the unit repaired or fixed somewhere. It was functional for 6 months or whatsoever, and the unit will be broken again. And then the repair guy say, okay, I repaired this, something another failed, and asking for more money and blah, blah, blah. So it's much more better and safer to deactivate the unit. And I am putting 12 months warranty for it, but I am doing it already for 5 years, and I do not have any single claim or any single unit returning back to me. Okay.